Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Mario Odyssey. Last time, we finished up here in the Snow Kingdom. We took part in the race and got ourselves a multi-moon, and then did just a little bit of exploring, but we're not going to be finishing that exploration for a little bit. We are actually going to head into the Odyssey, because we want to change our outfit, and we already bought one that we can change into. It's over here. We already bought one that we can change into, and that is right here, the mechanic outfit. So let's do that. I love this, because Mario wears his hat backwards, and he's got his little chicken bits of hair sticking out of the front. Mario's got an interesting hairstyle, I'll say that much. Alright, let's move on. Where are we headed, Cappy? Where are we headed? It would seem probably down to the one that we had the option to go do before. The Seaside Kingdom. I love this place. Let's go. So they're serving frost-frosted cake at the wedding, are they? Not if we serve them a defeat first! Seeing as how we've got some time to kill, have a ground pound jump, we know. There it is! Let's read up on the Seaside Kingdom. There's a carbonated sea that's supposed to be quite nice, and it says that, yeah, it says here to be sure to visit the four giant fountains. This place is so pretty. And it's also really hot, I think. Alright, welcome to Bub Lane, the Seaside Kingdom. I almost said snow time. That is not what this is. The Seaside Kingdom. Hello. What you doing?
The treasure hidden in this room is so cunningly hidden, even your eyes will be of no use.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Gotcha. I'm using the rumble. I feel. Over this way. HD Rumble makes this so easy. That's Goombas, never mind! You freaking... You tricked me. Is it right here? Is it right... here? I feel it. I love HD Rumble, can I just say that much? Right here? Right here. What the... Right here. What the heck? It's vibrating the most around there, and it's telling me to the right, because the right side of the controller is vibrating. There it is! Our very first Power Moon in the Seaside Kingdom. A rumble on the seaside floor. I know this is kind of an underwhelming start. We went into a cave, but... Anyway, the reason I love the Seaside Kingdom is, if you guys don't know, my favorite Mario game right by Odyssey is Super Mario Sunshine. So, this just makes me really freaking happy. This looks like some hint art. Uh-huh. Keep. Let's keep a look at that, shall we? Keep a snapshot of that. That is actually from the, I believe, the Metro Kingdom. I wonder what this could be. And there's our shop. A big old yellow dory is the shop. Oh, well, come on. This guy is the shopkeep. And it always moves around as well, so it's kind of a pain if you're trying to keep up with the shop. Or if you need to find it and it's moved. It's like you gotta sometimes swim out to it, for example. Shopping in Bub Lane. I will take it. But then also, I'm gonna buy that little pirate outfit right here. Yes, I'd like that. I'm gonna buy the pirate outfit so that we have it. Because, why would I not want to do that? Why would I not want to buy it so that we have it so we can change into it wherever we are? Especially in this kingdom, because I don't want to chase the shop around. Also because there's purple coins beneath the shop. Well, actually, does this shop not move? I know the purple one moves. Maybe the yellow one stays wherever the heck it is. Anyways, this place is fantastic. I love it. It reminds me of Mario Sunshine. That's why I love it. Let's go! Oh god. Go, go, go! Turbo over! That's easy enough if you just hold it in place. Boom! And get yet another Power Moon. Now, we do have an objective right here, but I think for right now, I just want to do some exploring, and if we come across the objective, then sure. But for right now, I am just exploring. Now, this right here, one of my favorite enemies to capture, if we could actually do it. This right here is, I really should have learned these names beforehand, but I didn't. This right here is Gushin. Oh my god, this dude is fantastic, and I just love the way he's implemented. So, Y to jet forward, B to jet upward, and you can fly. But, as you'll see, the water bubble's going down. If it goes all the way down, you fall. Momentarily. But, the second you touch water again, you refuel and come back. So, luckily most of this area is water, so we're all good. Also, it's got a set height, but if you land, the height resets, so you can go even higher up. So let's say we land on this thing, and then go up. Okay, we ran out of water, but we would be even higher up. Look at this little dude. Can we collect this Power Moon in this form? I don't think we can. So, that right there is our objective. We've got to break all these seals, hit this.
Me, Jolly Water, will never surrender the delicious bark of water.
And bonk that guy on his head a few times. That is basically the goal. That's all you've got to do. Just bonk him four times, and he's done. So, we're gonna do that kind of in passing, you know, as we come to stuff that we can bonk him with. We shall bonk him, but we're not gonna worry about bonking him as the primary objective. We're gonna explore, because the Seaside Kingdom is mostly underwater, and I mostly don't like water levels, as I'm sure you guys know. But this one is utilized pretty well as a water level, because they've got the cheap cheeps, you've got the gushions and stuff to move around with, so it works. It works a lot better as a water level than certain other water levels that I've seen in past games. So, yeah, there's also just stuff hidden everywhere, because obviously you can hunt for stuff above the ground, but there's also stuff hidden under the water. I mean, you can see through the water most of the time, which is nice, but still, what do you have to say? Also, I love how all these dudes have little mustaches. To climb the lighthouse, you must first dive down this underwater tunnel. Must we now? Must we do it as Mario, or can I bring a friend? I think there's Cheep Cheeps around here. I'm gonna see if I can- yeah, there's a Cheep Cheep. I'm gonna see if I can bring a Cheep Cheep up here. Also, look, it says Famicom on the back of our hat. That's great. Grab that ocean trench west, and then it starts to dive deeper as well. Well, this area starts to go deeper. I love it so much. I don't know. I don't like water levels, but I like this water level. Is that weird? Maybe that's weird. I don't know. I do believe there's a Power Moon under here somewhere. Maybe I'm going crazy. Do I just have to kill all of these guys? Pretty certain one of these little bumps hides a Power Moon. Maybe. No, maybe not. Maybe I'm going crazy. Alright, that's fine. Our coin count is going up like nuts. What is happening? Where'd we get all those coins? Alright, here we go. Can we bounce this boy in there? I do believe we can. They're scared of the Cheep Cheep. There we go. But does he come with us? He doesn't. That was a waste of time. They give us Cheep Cheeps down here too. Alright, that was a complete waste of time then. Go ahead, capture a Cheep Cheep. Alright, let's take a look around. This place is so somber and calm. I love this. Do we have purple coins hidden somewhere? I'm pretty certain there's purple coins in here somewhere. Oh, also, you can press A and B at the same time to do a little boost. I guess I just learned that now. Okay. Oh, there's a Power Moon, not purple coins. I'll take a Power Moon. Looking back in the dark waterway, I'm pretty certain there's also purple coins in here somewhere. Oh, hello! Look who's back! It's the eels! Is it you? Oh, that's an air bubble. Okay. I guess you don't have to come through here as a Cheep Cheep, but if you so wish, you may do so. Alright, no, nothing. I bet there's something in one of these eel's little burrows. Oh, there's some purples. Grab those. Real quick, there we go. Oh, hello. Hello, friend. Hello, how's it going? Yeah, it takes a couple seconds for the cheap sheep to actually start moving, which is kind of throwing me off a little bit, but... like when you're diving, at least, or rising. Well, actually, wait. You go like that and then press the button. Yeah, he goes immediately if you do it that way. Okay. Is that it? Is that everything? Take a look. Look at that. Look how pretty that is. We've probably missed something, but we'll get it later if we have. Let's get out of here. And I do believe there's also a checkpoint up here, so we can just teleport up here if we want to. Yep, checkpoint right there. Lighthouse, and of course, a power moon. Shall we bonk? I do believe we shall. He's not happy. Excellent work! Just two fountains to go. Yeah, so I guess that dude's just stealing the soda water. Because they did mention that all of this water is carbonated, so we're essentially just swimming around in soda right now. Which is pretty radical, if I do say so myself. Let's get down in this 8-bit pipe. 8-bit. Where are we at? Oh, we're at the top left. Okay, so yeah, there's multiple pipes here, and they all lead to different parts of this maze, which is pretty neat. I'll give it that. It's pretty neat. Can we make that jump now? Okay, good. Invisible block. I was about to say, we would have been kind of screwed and stuck in here. If not. Well, actually, no. We could have, could we get that cheap sheep, please? We could have just, teleported out of there. Is this the power moon? No, that's coins. There's a power moon just hidden in the ground somewhere, and I don't remember where it is. Alright, what about you, Mr. 8-bit pipe? Alright, you put us like dead center. Okay. Got the one power moon down here, and also some purple coins that I saw! Oh, you're kidding me, they screwed us out of that. Alright, well I guess we'll get coins from that. Okay, coins from that, maybe not. Cool, we missed out on the power moon. Can we still get... wait, what? Do we have to knock a Koopa down here? Is that something we can do? Alright, hold on. Let's get out of here. Real fast. And go... was it this one? This is the new one, right? I think. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Yeah, this puts us down here. So this allows us to get this Koopa and I guess do that. Oh, so you have to have gone down there first. Gotcha. And then we can crouch jump our way in here and get another power moon, okay. Ocean bottom maze hidden room. Now, I'm guessing in order to get that power moon up there, we just have to have not screwed up like I did before. So let's fix that, shall we? Let's fix that whole screwing up thing that just happened. And not have that happen again. Alright, let's see. Oh, actually, can we just use this dude? And do that? What does that take us to? I guess this- well, this will be for the purple coins, actually. Cool, so we'll knock that out while we are here. Like so. What is the music right now? Wait a minute. Why did the music just get really intense? That wasn't just me, right? I'm not just hearing things. I'm pretty certain the music just got crazy intense for a second. Excuse me. Thank you. Alright, so what we gotta do, go like this, and there we go. Okay, well, I just screwed ourselves out of it before. And there's the power moon, ocean bottom maze treasure. And we're out. And that just puts a warp pipe right there. Alright, let's keep going, shall we? Let's continue to explore. Mario, could you throw that down? Can you not throw down underwater? Maybe you can't throw down under- oh no, you can throw up underwater, so I guess you can throw down underwater. Okay, Mario, you were just being a little difficult, weren't you? Are any of you hiding anything? No? God, I swear, every time I think there's something hidden, there's absolutely nothing. I could also be thinking of post-game, because a lot of stuff doesn't appear until post-game. Or, you know, just until we've beaten this area. Also, I think I hear my dog chewing something. Minnie! Stop it! Yeah, don't look at me like that. Sorry for doing that in the middle of the episode. She's over there chewing something that's hanging off of my wall. So, something I've already scolded her for doing in the past, actually. So, she's gonna get a little telling off after this episode, I think. What else we got around here? Anything? Anything at all? It's nice down here, though. I mean, it doesn't matter if there's nothing down here for us to collect. It's just, it's nice to just hang out. You know? Give me those. Okay. Let's, oh, no, I see more purple coins. I see more purple coins! God, they're all over the place. I am not complaining. I like collecting things. Alright, what do we got? Oh, now she's barking. Alright. Welcome to having a puppy. God damn it, she's going nuts. Okay, folks, I think purely because of that, that's gonna have to be where this episode ends. You can probably hear her barking in the background. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.